Airtable can help you to organize and streamline practically anything. And while most of what I talk about on this channel is in relation to business use cases and how you can increase profits, increase efficiencies, yada yada, today we're going to be looking at a personal use case. I am tapping into my own personal stash, and I'm going to be sharing with you a database that I use literally every week to plan my meals, my dinners for the week. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I am the owner at Gap Consulting. We are a company that helps you to organize and automate your business using Airtable and other no-code tools. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, definitely check out the links below this video. And I want to invite you to join me for my upcoming webinar. Once a week, I hop online for a live webinar where I teach the fundamental building blocks of automation. So if you've been wishing that you had more time in the day, you could probably benefit from some Airtable and automation magic. Hop on into that webinar. Visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. You can sign up, and even if you can't attend the live event, you can get the replay sent to you so that you can start automating more and more of your work. But without further ado, let's hop into today's video. We are going to be looking at a database that I actually use to do my meal planning. I've recently made some updates to this, and although we did a previous video on this topic years ago, I've made a lot of enhancements to both my personal approach and also to the ancillary tools that I'm using, specifically some of the apps that I've added on to this particular database. I want to show you exactly how I use it to plan out my meals every week. And more than that, I'm even giving you access to this. So do check the links below in the description as well if you just want to download your own copy of this database so that you can start planning your meals in a similar way. So how are we going to come at this? Well, first and foremost, I need to describe to you the process that we follow in my house every time we plan out our meals. Then I'm going to walk you through the database structure and why I've structured it that way. And then lastly, I'm going to walk through an actual planning of meals for a particular week so that you can see exactly how easy it is to come up with my grocery list in a matter of a minute or two. So let's go ahead and jump on into that first part. What does it look like inside of my household when we are planning any meals for the week? Well, it's either going to be on Friday or Saturday that my wife and I sit down and we say, what are we eating this week? What have we had? What haven't we had recently? And what do you feel like? Generally, we try to include some different meals of different proteins. So we'll try to bring in a beef, a chicken, maybe a seafood. You get the idea. So a little bit of variety. And so that's always a nice thing to track. We also want to make sure that we're not repeating a lot of the same recipes week after week. And that was part of the purpose of building this in the first place, because we felt like we were just eating the same meals. And while they were good, it got a little boring just eating the same thing over and over again. So yes, we're looking to put together our meals really quickly. And again, I'm only assigning one meal per day because I'm only worrying about dinner. For lunch, everyone in my household kind of fends for themselves. It's dinner where we come together as a family. Now, another thing I want to point out is that we are not going to be starting with an existing inventory. I'm not keeping track of every single ingredient in my house. That would be crazy, way too much work. If you were using this for a business use case, you could definitely go to that level of crazy in your database if you're tracking inventory or something like that. But for my purposes, this is my household and this is just food in my refrigerator or in my pantry. No big deal. I don't need that level of precision or granularity. Okay, so this is what the process looks like. I sit down with my wife, we plan out what we want, and then we go through and we look to see what ingredients we already have. If we need, for example, cumin as a seasoning, then we look and we say, we already have half a thing of cumin, no big deal, we don't need to buy any more. So we can cross it off the list. And then we go through, order our food from Instacart. So we go into our Instacart app and just have the food delivered to the house. And we're able to mark it off as we put it in the Instacart app and put it in our shopping cart, essentially. We take it off of this list. So again, we're going to be checking the existing stock, and then we're taking it off of the list as we order it in our app. Okay, so that's the process. Let's jump into what we're going to do inside of our database. There are four main tables that we're looking at. We've got meals, we've got calendar, we have ingredients, and we have recipes. This is a big advancement from the previous video that I did 3 years ago, and I'll show you why. The first place I'm going to start is meals, where we have the name of the meal, and then we also label out the protein. This way we can make sure we're eating a variety of different foods, different proteins throughout the week. I also have a most recent date, and this is actually pulling from the calendar using a roll-up field, taking the max values. So I can see how recently I had this meal, which is great for planning. I can make sure that I'm not repeating the same meals over and over and over again in sequence. I also have a not like to buy field. I have a very picky daughter and she does not like to eat a lot of the things that we eat as a family. So I try to monitor this and make sure that we're not making meals that one or more of my family members don't like if they're gonna be home that evening for that particular dinner. Now I also have notes here, just a field that I don't personally use a whole ton, but if I wanted to take some notes on these recipes, I could do that as well. Now some more advanced things that you could bring in here would be the URL if you found this meal online, or you could even include an attachment if you have an actual PDF or some sort of file that includes the recipe. For my purposes, I don't worry about that because I have it stored in a hard copy somewhere else, so that's not something I added to this database. The idea here is that meals is then connecting to both the calendar, where we're saying when the meals are going to be planned, but also to recipes. And I'll get to recipes in just a second. So let's hop into the calendar. This is pretty straightforward. You can see that we just have one meal planned per day because we're only doing dinner, and it's showing up with the color of the protein. So I've already color-coded this to show up, and that way I can tell at a glance if I'm eating a variety of proteins throughout the week. I also track all records here, so these are all of the different records, but also the current week. And current week is going to show me only those meals that fall in the current week. And remember, because we do our planning on Friday and Saturday, I've already built some pretty fancy formulas in the background to allow for that. So I'm looking for a current week formula. Let me go ahead and pop open that current week formula here, and you can see that, sure enough, I'm looking at the current date, and I'm adding one to it, and I'm grouping all of this by the week. And so basically, this allows me to know which of the recipes that are in my overall calendar are the recipes that apply to the current week, because that's what I need to know when I'm putting together my current grocery list. All right, so go ahead and save that up. Now let's hop into ingredients. This includes a list of all the different ingredients that we use in our various recipes, as you would imagine. So we have categories like protein, spices, canned goods, etc. We also track our current quantity. This allows us to track how much we will need for the current week's production. And so the nice part about this is if we're using sour cream, let's say, in multiple recipes, it's gonna roll all of that sour cream up and give us a total. We might use 1 cup and then a half a cup in two various recipes, so we're gonna need 1.5 cups for the week. Now I also have that in stock and that ordered checkbox, and then I have a checked box here that's just telling me if it's both ordered and or in stock. So if it's ordered or in stock, I'm gonna get a checkbox here. And that's gonna come into play when we are looking at ordering our recipes throughout the week. Now I also have a unit that's determined per ingredient. And this gets a little confusing because a lot of spices, for example, might sometimes go in tablespoons and other times go in teaspoons. But in my case, I have to normalize that data. I have to say, this particular thing is always done in this unit. And so if I have a recipe, for example, that calls for 2 tablespoons, but let's say it's something like onion powder that by default is in teaspoons, then of course I know that I have to do the math on my recipe to include 6 teaspoons as opposed to 2 tablespoons. So a lot of conversions that I do in my head, again, that needs to happen though, just so that we can normalize the ingredient data, because otherwise we can't add it up. If I added up onion powder in teaspoons plus onion powder in tablespoons, the end result wouldn't make any sense. So I have to pick that common denominator. In this case, that's my unit. Whatever that is, it has to live at the ingredient level. Now let's go into our final table, recipes. And this is where we're gonna break down the meal and the ingredient line by line. Now this is a variation from our previous version of this template because this is where the junction table comes into play. Now, if you haven't heard about me talk about junction tables before, definitely check out our videos on junction tables because they're a critical part of building a really succinct database. What this allows us to do is essentially sum up the different quantities of ingredients and roll that back up into the current week. Only through this are we able to get the summation of ingredients that we use throughout a variety of recipes. So here in this example, if you were to look at the beef and blue cheese pesto penne, We're linking to that meal, and then we're also going through all the different ingredients with a specific quantity per ingredient, and I'm looking up the unit that's used for that ingredient. That's a lookup back to the ingredients table. So this is the structure of the database. If it seems a little complex, go ahead and access the database through the shared link that I've provided below, and go ahead and poke around in there. See where you're stuck or what doesn't quite make sense. The more you expose yourself to this, the more it will come together in your mind. Now for the final part of this, I'm gonna walk you through how I plan out my meals on any given week. We're gonna start by opening up the apps. Over here on the right-hand side, I've got a bunch of different apps working for me. One of them is a search, and I can search my different meals by protein. So for example, if I wanted to add some beef to my current week, I could just bring that up right here and look at the different beef recipes available to me in my meals table. Scrolling down, I also have my current week schedule, and this is going to come in handy when I'm looking over my ingredients. I'll be able to work with my ingredients on the left side of my screen and still look at the overall meal schedule on the right-hand app. And lastly, I've added this batch update. This allows me to, with the click of one button, just eliminate all the checked boxes in my ingredients. If we go back to that ingredients table, you'll see that I've got that in stock and the ordered checkbox here. This is only pertinent if I'm ordering things for the current week, right? Well, in this case, when I start a new week, I want to start from scratch. So all I have to do is hit update records, and you see it automatically removes all those checked boxes, which allows me to start with a clean template every week. Let's go ahead and jump into how I use this for meal planning. I'm gonna pop into my calendar and go to the actual calendar view, and sure enough, here I am on the 16th, able to start planning out my week. On the right-hand side, again, I have the ability to search through my different meals if I wanted to bring in a certain protein. Let me go ahead and see what non-protein I have available here. I'll be adding the butternut squash risotto to my meals this week. So let's say that was on Wednesday. I would just click here and go ahead and expand that record, and all I have to do is link it to the proper recipe. Butternut squash risotto is right there, and it's now added to my calendar. Now I can do the same thing. Let's say I'm gonna bring takeout in on this day. I'll go ahead and expand the record and add takeout. We pretty much have takeout every Friday. And then let's say I also wanted to do takeout on Monday because we're celebrating. I can go ahead and bring it in here. Now I can see that we haven't got a lot of different proteins out yet, so maybe I wanna add chicken tonight. I can come up here and search my chicken recipes. And just that easy, all of my chicken options are here. I'm gonna bring in the Mexican bake, so I can just add that here, expand here, and add it to my calendar. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill this out for a few more meals. And there we go, now I've planned out my week. I've added 7 recipes to take me through next Friday. Now for the next step, I've gotta get my grocery list automatically populated for me, so I'm gonna flip into ingredients, and I'm gonna go to current ingredients. And again, this app is so smart that what it's done, it's already brought all that information for me right here. So it knows all of the things that I require for the meals that I just put into my calendar for the current week. This is all done by the filter, right? Because we're looking at the filter that's looking for the current quantity required in the upcoming week. And just that easy, I can look and see all the different ingredients that I'm gonna need in order to prepare the 7 meals that I just established. Now what I do is I go through and I mark off what's in stock. I'll go to my pantry and say, you know what? I've already got canned corn, I have diced tomatoes, we're good there. Okay, I've got goat cheese in stock, I have limes from last week, and maybe I've got pecans, right? Whatever that is, I'm able to remove these things from my grocery list because I know I already have them in stock. Very often, I'll remove a bunch of the spices as well because, as you imagine, you don't have to buy spices every week. So let's say I've removed a bunch of stuff here and now I'm ready to put in my Instacart order and get groceries delivered. I flip into Need to Order, and this is now filtered only to include those things that I haven't yet ordered and I do not have in stock. So since I already went to the current ingredients view and I marked off what's in stock, that stuff is not showing up in my need to order view. So now I just pop open my Instacart app and I get in there and I start ordering food. As I'm ordering the different ingredients, I'm just marking it off. And as it gets ordered, it gets removed from this view until there's nothing left. At the end, I've got my fully baked grocery list inside my app, push send, the order gets delivered a couple of hours later, and that's it. That simple, just within a few moments, I have planned out my meals for the entire week and got all my groceries ordered for those recipes. Now, the only time that I get slowed down is if a meal or a recipe isn't already in the system. So in the case where a recipe's not in the system, I have to add it. I do that by coming down to add a record. And when I start here, I'm gonna have a new grouping here, a new recipe that hasn't yet been tied to a meal. So let's suppose, for example, that I didn't have a recipe in for the sous vide steak and veggies. I need to add that. I scroll on down and I have to build this out. So I would have to add the different ingredients. Let's say, sirloin steak. How many pounds? One. Veggies, what are we doing with this? Maybe Brussels sprouts. In this case, Brussels sprouts isn't even in the ingredients list yet, so I add a new record named Brussels sprouts, and maybe this comes in a bag. Remember, this is a lookup field, so I have to look up the Brussels sprout ingredient here. Let's go ahead and find the Brussels sprouts that I just created. Make sure we're on the all ingredients and search for Brussels. Here it is. What is the unit? Well, in this case, we'll go with bag, right? So a bag of Brussels sprouts, or maybe in your grocery store, it's pounds. Whatever the case may be, however you like to measure that, set your units there, and then I can pop back into my recipes and determine how many pounds of that I need. And just like that, I'll go step by step, putting all the ingredients in, and now the next time I put sous vide steak and veggies on my meal planning, the whole recipe is instantly there. So of course, you're gonna need to do this first before you go ordering any groceries. If you haven't yet planned the recipe in the database, there's no way the database can tell you what you need to order. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. And again, if you wanna check out the template, do check the links below this video and get instant access to that once you've shared your email address. Leave any questions you have below, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.